Islam promoted the sciences from the inception. Our deen, our religion began with what? Iqra, recite. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah did not send down a disease except that he sent down for it a cure. Whoever knows it, and whoever doesn't, doesn't. Meaning go look for it. So the likes of this is what spearheaded Islamic civilization, where their religion and their worldly life, they went hand in hand. And that's why you have, for example, in the 10th century, Avicenna, Ibn Sina. The Qanun, the canon of Ibn Sina, was the medical library in Europe for longer than any other book in history. In the 9th century, you have Al-Khawarizmi, the father of algebra. The Columbia History of the World says that modern trigonometry, algebra, and geometry are in considerable measure Arab creations. They mean Muslim creations. The 10th century, Al-Hazen. You may not know there's a crater on the moon that they call Al-Hazen. It was named after Al-Hazen, meaning Al-Hasan ibn al-Haytham. Why was it named after him? Because of his contributions to optics and his discussions on luminosity. And he vanguarded, he started the discussions on the experimental method. The House of Wisdom, Baytul Hikmah in Baghdad, centuries ago. That was the world's largest repository of books. No one valued books the way we did. There were more books in a street of Baghdad than there existed in cities in Europe. This is just a testimony that Islam can and has been able to maintain economies and ethics. Islam can and has balanced between materialism, this dunya, and spirituality, the spirit, and the religion. Islam can and has ensured prosperity and happiness and peace in this world and salvation in the hereafter.